deciding on a correct down payment for a house. I am in the process of making an offer for a house. Wife and I have about 135k saved, with steady jobs, both happen to be an essential business as required for this period during the coronavirus. Initially, I wanted to put 20% down, about 74k, to avoid PMI and have lower monthly payments. I have since reversed course on this. I think 10%, about 37k, is better, and here is my reasoning. PMI calculators online suggest the PMI will be about 150 a month. 37k invested returns should be more than double the yearly PMI payments during an average year. We plan on being in this house for the foreseeable future, so I am playing the long game with this chunk of investment. We can also have the option to make a chunk payment in the future to bring it to 20% equity and get the PMI taken off if we choose. Also, this gives us access to this cash in a more liquid form during these unsure times. Does this reasoning make sense? With a long-term outlook, would it still be wise to sink the extra 37k into the house and get rid of the PMI?
Short answer. It probably makes sense to avoid the PMI, private mortgage insurance, but it ultimately depends on how probable it is that you are unable to pay the monthly installments without the extra savings. Long answer. While I am not an expert on the specifics of the U.S. mortgage market, I presume the question pertains to U.S., it seems that a PMI or an increment of the overall interest rate charged on the loan varies between 0.5% and 2% PA, and is charged on the overall loan amount, 90% in this case. Your loan amount works out to $333K from the provided information and your annual PMI payment to $1,800. This puts it on the lower end with 0.54%. That means that with the 37K you plan to invest instead of paying down, you have to earn 4.9% PA, plus the normal mortgage interest rate on those 37K, all this net of tax, assuming you get no tax deduction on your mortgage PMI payments. This seems like a tall order compared to a risk-free savings you realize by having a lower mortgage interest rate on the overall loan amount without the PMI. So based on risk, return considerations alone, you are probably better off avoiding the PMI. Only a very low PMI rate would result a different outcome from that perspective. Another consideration to make is whether putting the 37k aside instead of using them for a down payment would improve your worst case scenario and could buy you additional time in case you have difficulties repaying the mortgage. Only you can figure out how much this option is worth, considering how secure your and your spouse's incomes are, what are you going to do with the 61k that remain even if you choose to pay down, and how much the monthly mortgage repayment is, compared to your income. Based on the information you provided, it seems that the 61k can last you for a significant period of mortgage repayments, so that the value of any additional cushion is probably very small.